So basically what we are starting today is we are going to study, it will just take some minutes, it won't take much time. We are going to study what are the methods to control interfering and modifying inputs. We already know that these inputs are not required in the system. Interfering is something which is from the environment and modifying is something which is modifying the inherent system of the, what you can say, inherent measurement system of yours. Okay, so this interfering and modifying are not required actually. Some way it can be beneficial if you want to increase your signal value. If you want to increase your input value so that you get a good output value. If it helps in that way, then you can consider to have the interfering and modifying signal into your system. But more or less, you don't require it. Why you don't require it? Because you design an instrument. Okay. When you design an instrument, you design it with respect to desired input. You don't design it with respect to interfering and modifying input. Okay. So basically, what we actually require is desired input only. We don't require modifying and interfering input. So how do we control? First is controlling the inherent insensitivity. Okay. The second method that I have mentioned is high gain feedback. The third is signal filtering. The fourth one is opposing input. And the fifth one is output correction. I'll just get into detail of some of these methods of how to control interfering and modifying input. So what I'll do is I'll just go to the next slide. I'll just take the next slide. Okay. This method is controlling the inherent sensitivity. Now, what do you mean by inherent? Something which is inbuilt. Okay. Inherent matlab something which is there in the system, already there in the system, already inbuilt. So what do we try to do? We try to make the system insensitive to the variation. Okay. What do we do in this? Making the system inherent insensitive is we try to make system insensitive to all other variation. How do we make it? Suppose we know that, suppose this is a, you can see this figure. I'll just change the color. If you see this figure, you can actually get it. This is a tape. Okay. But this tape is a steel tape. This tape is a steel tape. Okay. This is made up of steel, some kind of a steel. And this is actually used in construction sites. Okay. Where you want to measure the, suppose the site, you want to measure the site dimensions in an open environment where there will be introduction of temperature. Matlab, you know that environment is having some kind of a temperature. Okay. And you want to, you want your tape that it should not get affected by the temperature of the environment. Okay. It should remain unaffected. So now you already know which thing might affect my system. Okay. What is the input? What is the interfering input that might affect my system? So what I'll do is I'll try to control this temperature. Okay. I'll try to control this temperature. So to control this temperature, there is also plastic tape, which we normally use for measurement. And there is also a metal tape, which we use for construction sites. Okay. Now we know that if the temperature of the surrounding is more, there might be some deviation in the plastic. Okay. It might be in microns. The deviation might be in microns, but you already know that this microns might affect your total dimensioning. Okay, so what you'll do, rather than using the plastic tape, what you'll try to use is metal tape. That material that is used as a metal tape, that is called as Invar. Okay, that material is called as Invar. Invar is a type of material which is commonly called as 64Fe nickel. 64Fe matlab 64% of iron content it is having, and remaining percentage will be of nickel. So what is remaining out of 100 is 36% nickel. So this is used for measuring tapes in construction. Because what you can do, you can control the temperature of the environment. Matlab, it will, the temperature of the environment will not affect your measurement. So what you are trying to do, you are trying to make your system, measurement system, insensitive to variation. Okay. I hope everyone understood with this thing. Done. So this is the one type. Now we will get to the next type. The next type is, I have already mentioned you all the types. Okay. The next type is high gain feedback. Okay. Now, what do you mean by high gain feedback? Suppose this is my input. My input is coming from this end, right? My input is coming from this end. And I know that my input will also have some interfering input as well as modifying input. Now, I know that with respect to this input, we know that V is equal to IR. I'll just take white color. We know that V is equal to IR. So we know that V is proportional to I if resistance is kept constant. We already know this thing. So suppose I am giving some input as a current. Okay, my input is current. So my output will be what? My output will be voltage. We already know this thing. So I already know what should be my value with respect to this relation. With respect to this relation, I already know what should be the value of the voltage that I should get. So what I'll do, I'll use some kind of a control system. Okay, I'll use some feedback loop and I'll feed whatever should be the value. I'll feed that value. Suppose for 10 ampere, I should get 40 volt. Okay, so I'll feed this value into my feedback loop, into my control system. I'll already feed this value. Now, when I take this input, and if this input is having interfering as well as modifying component, my output, which is nothing but a voltage, I hope, suppose I got 50 voltage. Okay, I got higher value. So what will happen? This value, whatever I am getting here, okay, 50 voltage, this will return to the feedback system. Okay, once it returns to the feedback system, I'll get some error here. What will be the error? I'll be automatically. There can be two ways of controlling, automatic or can be manual. Okay, so depends upon the system. What I'll do, I'll change my input. I will change my input. Suppose I know that 10 ampere should give 40 voltage. And 10 ampere is giving me which value? Suppose 10 ampere is giving me 50 voltage. So I'll try to reduce my voltage. Okay. Either I will do it myself manually or the system will do it automatically. Since that interfering and modifying input is giving me a good voltage. And what will be that interfering and modifying input? Suppose there is a magnetic field. I hope everyone is understanding. Now this magnetic field is doing what? It is increasing the voltage. There is some induced voltage, induced EMF, which is increasing my voltage of the system. Okay. So what will happen? Since I know that I'm getting more voltage, okay, now I'm getting more voltage. Since I'm getting more voltage, I'll decrease my current. So this is the way where how we can control our input by a system which is called as high gain feedback. This is also known as feedback loop system. Has everyone understood this? Is there any doubt? Just put it in the chat box. Please put it fast. We have only 5 minutes to complete. Put it in the chat box. Is everyone okay? Just put it in the chat box. Pakka, should I proceed? Anyone else? Put it in the chat box. We don't have much time. Only 15 students have come for the lecture. This is not good. Not an issue. I don't teach to... Okay. We'll get to the next type. The next type that I'm going to explain is signal filtering. Opposing output is used in orifice plate to control flow rate. And there is one more, which is called as output correction. We will just see one type, which is signal filtering. So for explaining you signal filtering, this is the way to control the output. Okay. Input, various types of input. So what I'll do, I've already drawn something for you so that we don't waste our time in the lecture. Okay, now this is a basic example that I have taken for signal filtering. Okay, now what I'll do is I'm trying to explain you signal filtering. Suppose my input, I'll just take a good color. Suppose my input is current, okay, and my output is suppose voltage. So what I have written, 0 to 100 voltage, I have written volt, and 0 to 100 ampere I have mentioned. Okay. Now suppose we already know according to Ohm's law, V is proportional to I. So we also know that I is proportional to V and we know that V is equal to IR. So suppose I am providing some current. With respect to that current, I am getting some kind of an input. Okay. So with respect to 100, I'll just change it. With respect to this 100 signal, okay, I am getting 100. So this is nothing but linear. This is linear. Okay, we already know that this kind of system is called linear. Now, suppose in signal filtering, there are four kinds of system. First is no pass. What happens in no pass? I don't want any signal to pass only. So, suppose there is zero. Okay, I am providing 0 ampere and I am getting 0 volt. I am providing 40 ampere. I hope you can see. And I am getting what value? I am getting 40 volt. Okay, so what do we do in this system? We don't want any signal to get passed only. So this kind of system is called as zero pass or no pass. Okay. We can say it as zero pass or no pass. We are not allowing any value from 0 to 100. My range is 0 to 100 ampere. And for 0 to 100 ampere, we don't want any kind of output. Okay, so this kind of system, signal filtering, input signal filtering is called as zero pass signal filtering or no pass signal filtering. I'll get to another type for you. After zero pass, this same diagram we will take. I'm just taking one more example. Okay, after zero pass, what I'm assuming, just look at this. Suppose this is high pass. What I'm saying, this is high pass. And what range I am using? I want all the signal which is above 40 ampere input voltage to pass. So it will suppose what I'm saying, 0 to 100 was our reading. So it will pass all the signal above 40. Whatever might be the value of signal from 40, okay, to 100 ampere. What is the voltage? The voltage from 40 to 100 ampere is how much? 60 volt. So it will only pass this value. Okay, this is called as high pass. Similarly, there can also be called as low pass. What will happen in low pass? Suppose I only want signal of less than 40 ampere input to pass. Okay, so what will happen? Only this much signal will pass. Okay, this will not show any signal. Just like in this case, there was no signal here. So this will not show any signal above this. Only signal that will pass is this value. I hope you're getting. This will be my input. Sorry, this will be my voltage and this will be my input, which I have plotted on y-axis. I hope you understood. What are the different methods? Put it in the chat. Done? Okay. There can be one more method that I would like to explain you. I'll just put it here only. There is one more system. I'll just put it in rough for you. One is low pass. What you have seen, no pass or zero pass. Signal filtering, then it can be low pass, then it can be high pass, and then it can also be band pass. What do you mean by band pass? Suppose this is my system, okay, and I want the signal only to pass from 40 to 60 volt, or suppose from 40 to 60 ampere, okay, 40 ampere to 60 ampere. I want only this much signal to pass. So this is called as, suppose this, here there is no signal passing, here is there is no signal passing from 0 to 100 ampere. I'm only allowing the signal to pass from this to this value. So this is called as band pass. What do we call it as? Band pass. Done? Okay. So there are various kinds of signal filtering that we can use. One is low pass. Another is high pass. Then it is zero pass or no pass. And then it can be band pass. Okay.